Today I'm going to show you how to use animation to make your website come to life. If you do any kind of corporate or commercial work, I guarantee eventually you're going to have to animate either a website or an app. Now there's a couple ways of going about this. The easy way is to screen record yourself going through the app and clicking on features, but I'm going to show you how to take it to the next level using some animation. Now let's assume you don't have a file to work with that has the web page split up into layers. That's okay, you can work around this. What we're going to have to do is scroll down the website and take some screenshots of each section. Once I've screenshotted all of the sections I need, I'll go into Photoshop. From here, I'll basically make a panorama of the website by stitching together the screenshots. Now we'll have a high resolution image of the whole homepage. We can start by using the clone stamp tool to get rid of the URL. I want to add that in later in After Effects so it can be animated on. Next, we'll go in and start splitting up the page into different elements. We want everything at the top of the page to animate individually, so I'm going to cut and paste each object into different layers. Now we're left with a bunch of holes in the background layer. These are easy to fill in if you're working with a simple, solid color background like this, but it could get tricky if you're working with a detailed background. Fill in all the holes so we're left with a completely solid homepage. Turn all of the layers back on, and we should be left with the original website looking exactly like it did in the beginning. At this point, we're ready to bring it into After Effects and start animating. Inside of After Effects, I'm going to start by making a new text layer to fill in the URL bar. I recommend doing this in After Effects because it gives you the option to animate each character individually. Now I'm going to add an opacity animation to the text and give it a typing on effect. For this to work properly, we're going to want to change the units to index, so the letters animate one at a time and not by percentage. From here, we're going to animate the start keyframe on the range selector so that our letters appear one by one. You're going to see the next letter fading in early, so to fix that, turn the smoothness down to zero. To look like the Safari browser, I keyframe the position of the URL to start at the side and shoot over to the middle after typing. Make sure you turn on motion blur to really sell the effect. Finally, I added a cursor by creating a line and then keyframing the position to match the typing on of the text. Now that we have the URL section done, we can move on to the actual homepage. I kept it pretty simple on this one by fading in most of the elements. I wanted the photo to appear by dropping down instead of just fading on, so I keyframed the position so that it would drop in behind the menu bar. Then I created a shape covering everything above the menu and set the track mat of the photo layer to alpha inverted. This means any part of the photo that appears inside of this shape we just made is invisible, giving us the effect that the photo is coming out from behind the menu bar. So now I'll keyframe some of the remaining elements to fade on, and our homepage animation is complete. Pre-comp all of your layers and make your new composition 3D. Now we can add a new camera to create some movement in our shot. At this point, it's just a matter of setting keyframes for the point of interest, position, and orientation of the camera, and then position the website where you want at the start and at the end of your animation. Now this technique allows you to get a lot more creative with your edit while still maintaining a high quality, sharp image. If you like what you see, I'll be releasing a new video every week covering different topics, so make sure to hit that subscribe button and leave a comment below letting me know what topics you'd like me to cover. Thanks for watching, see you again next week.